اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سبط الرحمة وإمام الهدى المدفون بأرض كربلاء المنحور عطشانا بلا خطا سيدنا ومولانا أبي عبد الله الحسين بن علي. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي. حججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائمة. اللهم وصل على ولي أمرك القائم المؤمل والعدل المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
Every Imam of the Ahl al-Bayt, in fact, every Ma'soom that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent for the guidance of the human race, faced atrocities and hardships, mostly at the hands of their enemies. But Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam is that unique individual who probably faced the hardest of hardships, the most severest of hardships, at the hands of the very same people who called themselves the Shi'as of Ahl al-Bayt. Especially after doing the sulh with Muawiyah alayhi salam. After Imam alayhi salam signed the peace treaty with Muawiyah to safeguard his life and the life of his loved ones because of the level of treachery that had reached in his camp, the same people who yesterday were calling him their Imam, who were calling him their Mawla, came, and then the same people were stabbing him in his legs. The same people were calling him names. The same people would come and greet him with Assalamu alayka ya mudhill al-mu'minin. May salams be on you, or the one who has humiliated the believers. And that treachery, that level of committing atrocities towards Imam, has not ended yet. Even till today, that Imam is mazloom at the hands of the very people who call themselves the Shi'as and the lovers of the Ahl al-Bayt alayhim as-salam. And you only need to see proof of that in a few nights' time when we come and gather to pay our respects and commemorate the martyrdom of this great Imam. You will see by the level of attendance how valued we find this Imam. One day, a so-called companion of Imam came in to Imam alayhi salam. This was at the time when, for the third time, Muawiyah had fed him with the poison. And the poison began to take its effect. The man came and he says, "Oh Imam, your amr is ajib. You are puzzling us." He said, "What do you mean?" The man said, you were commanding an army of 40,000. And we were in numbers probably greater than what they were. Yet at that, in a position of strength, you did the sulh." Imam at the time said a few words that maybe we will not fathom the importance and the wisdom and the genius behind what Imam did till the day of judgment, maybe. Imam alayhi salam said to him, Have you read the story of Musa and Khidr in the Quran?" The man said, "Yes." Imam said, "Musa alayhi salam, in the eyes of Allah, was the greatest individual on the face of the earth at the time." And I'm expanding Imam's words. At the time, Musa was the greatest, the closest, the most pious, the most revered individual in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of that of the earth at that time. Yet Musa had a deficiency and Allah wanted to complete him. He had a particular knowledge which Musa had not acquired yet. So Allah, to educate Musa, takes him on a journey to meet Khidr. Musa, at that high status of closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, could not fathom and could not tolerate and could not bear the three things that the Quran narrates that Khidr was doing. The beginning of the journey was they ascended on a boat. As they ascended on a boat and they're in the heart of the sea, he finds Khidr is digging a hole in the boat. I don't know much about you, but if you're flying in a plane and somebody's chiseling away at the window, I don't know what you would do, but I know what I would do. And so this was the case. He was chiseling at the at the window of the aeroplane. He was digging a hole in the boat. You're going to sink us and sink all these people who have paid good money to board this boat. Khidr said to him, you won't understand. And they moved on. The next thing he sees, he finds that a young man is just walking around peacefully. Khidr takes out his dagger and stabs him and kills him. Now Musa, the prophet of Allah who has come to install love and peace amongst the human beings, he's saying, you have just killed an innocent person. What are you doing? Khidr said to him, you won't understand. And then they go starving out of food. There's no food. They've got no water. They've just been traveling for 3 days. They come into a town and they find that a wall needs to be built. So Khidr says, come on, Musa, help me out. And together they build the wall and then they walk away. Musa said to him, we're starving. We're dying of thirst. Ask for a little bit of water or some food. Khidr said to him, no, that's not the purpose behind this. He says, you won't understand. He said, so Musa said, we've just worked for free then? This is what we would do, of course. Imam alayhi salam takes the mind of that individual to that time. He said, Musa at his height could not understand things that were in ghaib. Because Khidr alayhi salam was not doing this out of his own accord. Khidr had attained the level of understanding ghaib. He was now committing, he was now executing the amr of Allah, the will of Allah. It was Allah's will that the ship should have a little bit of deficiency in it. It was Allah's will that that person should die. It was Allah's will that the wall should be erected. Yet Khidr had access to that knowledge. And Musa had not acquired that level yet where he had access to that knowledge. And so to Musa at his height, he was not able to understand the wisdom and the genius behind what Khidr was doing. Imam alayhi salam says, I have done by Allah, Imam says. He says, what I have done for my Shias is great with this sulh is greater than anything the sun has shone over. Imagine how much benefit the human race has taken from the sun from the day that Adam came, and even before Adam, the human race existed, from that time till the end of time. How much benefit will we draw from the sun? Imam says, by Allah, by signing this peace treaty, I have done more benefit to my Shias and to the believers than anything the sun has ever shone over. Then he said, what I have done is what Khidr had done too in the story of Musa. Today we find out that Imam, one of the benefits of signing that peace treaty was that Imam alayhi salam was able to prepare the ground for Karbala. Imam alayhi salam was able to prepare companions such as Hur. Imam alayhi salam was able to prepare companions such as Burayr and Habib ibn al-Madahir al-Azdi. So that tomorrow Karbala takes place. Until today, we are seeing the benefits of Karbala. Who had a direct hand to play in that? Imam al-Hasan alayhi salatu wasalam. These are Allahumma salli ala Muhammadan wa ala Muhammad. When the ulama sit on the pulpit and they say, for as long as Karbala remains alive, we remain alive, and freedom remains alive, and peace and justice remains alive, they're not talking out of emotions and to arouse your emotions. No, there is psychological and sociological traits within this statement that could be discussed over a whole 10 nights. Today, what Fir'aun of the time was doing at the time of Musa was that when he wanted to suppress the people underneath him, he belittled them and he killed their characters. And he committed such atrocities. The Quran says, يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَيَسْتَحِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. He would kill their men and their young ones, and he will oppress their women folks. And this is the same trait that Muawiyah and Yazid were committing at the time with the Muslims. And it is the same silah, the same weapon that today's atrocities, that today's kings and queens and superpowers of the world are using to suppress the freedom of the people. Yet Imam alayhi salam says that I built Karbala. I had a part to play in what Karbala took in Karbala. And for as long as Karbala remains alive, no free human being can ever remain suppressed and under the hands of oppression. إن أحسن الحديث وأبلغ الموعظة كتاب الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Finally, for the hastening of our Imam, for the advent of our Imam, and for the quick recovery of all those who are not well, and for peace and tranquility to all those who are oppressed around the world, please recite Surah Al-Mubarakat Al-Fatiha, preceded with a loud salawat.